Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're checking out some of the most insane plugins that will revolutionize the way you're designing. They'll change the design process entirely. Both for XD and Figma, I'll divide this video into two portions. The first portion will be for Figma, the second portion will be for XD. Even if you're an XD user, you can always check out Figma and vice versa, just to see what you guys are missing out on. Also, before we even begin with the video, I am doing a live session on Clubhouse with my friend Ansh Mehra, who's a designer at Zuddle. We'll be talking about the future of design, things that we can predict, things we can't. And you don't even need a Clubhouse invite for this. All you need is the app installed on your phones, and the link will be in the description. You can always use that link to join that Clubhouse and just be prepared for the event this Sunday. All right, so beginning with Figma, we have a bunch of cool entries. The first plugin we're looking at is called Breakpoints. And the special thing about Breakpoints is that it allows you to create a completely responsive and adaptive website based on the size of your artboard. So as you change your artboard, so will the design on your page. Let's look at it. So just to give you a quick reference, I've created this artboard. I'll widen it up. And in this case, I will just create a simple rectangle. And then you'll be able to see what I mean by this. So I'm going to give this a red color and a big rectangle. You know, I will create another artboard, which will be much smaller. In this case, maybe half of this. So I'm going to divide this by two itself. And I'm going to bring the rectangle in the middle and decrease the size of the rectangle. Of course, I will do another thing, is just change the color for the sake of, you know, representation, and show you what I mean by this. And I'll duplicate this one quickly and make another smaller artboard, which will be our more or less our mobile interface. In this case, the rectangle will be smaller again, and the color this time will be different, maybe something like a green. Now, once I've created this, I will bring up the breakpoints right here and I'll say new adaptive layout. As you can see, we've already created this adaptive layout, brilliant, and I'll click on this add button real quick. This will create an artboard here. As you can see, we will have different points, 320, 600, and 960, which means web, tablet, and mobile. Now, in this case, what we need to do is, first of all, we need to set one for mobile. And in this case, I'm going to select this frame, which is frame 3. And this will add this frame 3 as one of the breakpoints. And if I add this, the second one, I want it to be 600 to 960, which means we will be choosing this tablet right here. And we have added that as well. So now if I move between these two points, as you can see, the rectangle is changing right here. Of course, the height is different. We can adjust the height. As you can see, we can change the height as much as we want, but we'll get these points, of course. And if I reduce this, see how the rectangle changed. The best part about this is that we can even add breakpoints for the height. So if you want something to happen on the height as well, if we increase or decrease it, we'll be able to add those as well. And any changes that you're making while you're in this mode right here in your original artboards, for example, this I want to change to a purple or a pink, that change will be made here. Or if I want to change the position, as you can see, it's live. Another great plugin is called Fig 3D. Now, you've seen a lot of simple 3D tools like Spline come in, and this adds the Spline capabilities or 3D tool capabilities to your Figma. And I'm going to show you something really special about it. So first of all, I'm just going to create a square here with a random color, maybe like a deep blue or a deep purple. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up that plugin. And once I've brought up that plugin, it will show me various options to convert this into a 3D object. Now here it's a 2D object in a 3D space. I can always drag it around to see how it will convert in 3D. Wow, look at this. This is amazing. You can even change the floor, the shadow, everything here. If I don't want a shadow, I can just simply remove it. I can even change the opacity of the shadows and how the light is working. I can even change the exposure, so how much light is being reflected, if it's dark, if it's light. I want it to be bright enough, so this is cool. And I can even change the light settings, how intense the light should be, the shadow focus, so the more focus there is, the darker it is. The less focus it is, it's lighter and kind of fades away. You can even change how much the shadow should spread, the angle of shadow, angle of lighting, everything from here, which is amazing. You can even change ambient intensity. So how much light should there be in the environment? This is what it defines. And the best part is you can download it as a render. Yes, an actual rendered object as a PNG, or export as a 3D model if you want to export this as a GLTF into other 3D tools like Spline or Cinema 4D. You can do this from right inside here, which means that you get the capability of either using it in Figma or just exporting it quickly for changes in a Cinema 4D or anything else. You can even change how large this should be. If you want it to be high definition, big, you can change it from 1x to something like 8x and say insert in Figma. It will take a few seconds only and it will add it right there inside Figma. The best part is this tool will work with any SVG. It will work with any image, rectangle, shape, whatever you like. You can convert to a 3D object, which I think is fantastic. Now, I'm sure some of you are beginners in Figma and you're having a difficult time understanding the tool. Rather than going to YouTube or any other platform, you can use a plugin called Figma Tips. What it allows you to do is it has a bunch of these tips inside Figma, and you can always play videos inside your Figma files. I'll quickly give you a glimpse of this. If I open Figma Tips from right here inside Figma, it takes you to this little window right here. And inside this, you can choose from a bunch of topics right here. So if you want to understand how components work inside Figma, you can quickly click on one of these. And what it does is it expands and creates a video element right here. So while you are designing here in the background, you can look at this YouTube video in front. A great part is that you can quickly add links to your canvas. Now, in case you want to come back to this tutorial, you just click on this little element and it will take you right into this Figma Tips plugin right here. Or you can just search quickly for whichever topic you like. So, for example, I want color, and there will be a bunch of things about colors, CSS, tricks on fire, etc. I absolutely love this plugin and how easy and quick it is to use and get started with. Now, there are so many things we do manually inside Figma. What if we could automate all those tasks? If we paste something, it should be pasted a certain way. If we create a group, it should be named a certain way. There are different things we can do with Automator right here. And it's wonderful because it shows all the capabilities right in front, so you can see whether this is a plugin for you. These are basically creating custom shortcuts in Figma, and I think that's brilliant. If I quickly get into this, now I'll show you how these shortcuts work. So if I create, say, a rectangle right here, if I get into this finder window right here, or this search window right here, by clicking Command P or Control P, and if I type in Automator, as you can see, we have a bunch of things we can do with Automator right from the front here. So we can say frame each, and what it'll do is it'll convert this little triangle into an actual frame. So if we had a bunch of images or rectangles, we wanted to do it with multiple frames or multiple rectangles, we could just click on all those rectangles and it would do that for us. Now we're always stuck with the default font that we have. What if we could just change or edit the fonts we wanted in a certain way, just like we wanted? That is where Variable Fonts comes in. It's a cool little plugin, and I'll quickly bring up Variable Fonts from the window here. So for example, I want a font like Work Sans, which is a regular font just like this. And I want to now edit this font and then add it to my name here. So what I'll do is quickly, I'll go to the styles here. I can quickly make changes like colors, of course, opacity, things like that. I can even change the axis, which means the weight of the font. You can give it super thin or super thick. Again, even if a font doesn't have one of these weights, it will just add the weight here. And we can name these. So I can say super fat right here. I can even edit the glyphs, all these custom letterings, the things that we don't get in the default pack, we can add here. And all I need to say is add. Now, the thing is, it's added this as a vector and not a text. So again, you can only edit it inside this right here. And you can always change it to your name or whatever, and it will make the changes right here live itself. Again, a great way to edit the fonts that you already have in a certain way. Last but not the least for Figma is one of my favorite, because I love gradients personally. And Mesh Gradients is a plugin which allows you to create complex gradients with different points with different colors altogether. So if I go inside Figma real quick and I say mesh gradients, it will bring up this plugin. Now, as you can see, this is a website or an app in itself. You can change where these points land. You can even add more points by clicking on one of these options, 3x3. So basically we'll add 9 points in total, 4x4, it'll add 16 points. So you can create super complex gradients as well. If I click on any one of these points, it brings up one of these options. You can change the color from right here. You can choose between hex, RGB, or HSL, which is cool. You can even reset a color if you don't like the new one. You can even allow it to have lines so that you can see where the mesh is landing or where the color is spreading to. And of course, if you're confused, you can always quickly randomize and it will create a random mesh with random colors. Look at this. This is amazing. And you can quickly save these gradients by clicking on save right here. And it's saved inside your Figma. It will never go away. You can open it up quickly and add it. And I'll probably be creating wallpapers for my phone, backgrounds for websites and apps with this plugin right here. Now, enough love to Figma. Let's move on. Onto Adobe XD. Adobe XD users, I'll never forget about you. Now, the first plugin for XD solves a huge problem that exists in XD. You can't scale all the elements in XD based on a certain point. The scaling happens only in a horizontal direction. What if you want to do custom scaling inside XD? I'm going to quickly show this to you guys. Now, if I want this to be a certain width, I can quickly change it from your things like maybe something like 800 pixels. And as you can see, it's changed it from the right. It's increased from the right to the left. If I wanted to do it from the left, we could do that also. See how it changes the width from the left to the right. This way things will shift from the left to the right here. Now you can even say scale corners, which means it'll scale the border radius along with it. You can scale shadows, so it will increase or decrease the shadows. You can say scale strokes, so it will increase or decrease the strokes based on the size of the element itself. These are things that don't exist already in XD, and Transform fixes the scaling issues or the size issues inside XD. The next plugin is called X-Ray. This is one of the most useful plugins that I've found in XD. And as you can see, I've already installed and started to use it. It allows you to scan your entire XD document. You can check whether things are the way you want it. So if a color is different from all the other colors, you can change it back. You can then click on approve and it will basically go forward and you can say, okay, this is the final design. Quickly show you how it works. I'll quickly go inside XD here and I'll go to the bottom. And as you can see, X-Ray exists here. And the best part is you don't need to select things. You just need to click on scan right here and it will scan the entire document for you. So it's basically doing a check or a cleanup. As you can see, there are things here. There is a width. So it says, okay, broadcast display has a certain width, which is 375. So there are two different opacities. It allows you to select the opacity and it highlights the opacity right here. So if you feel there is a weird opacity, maybe if you want all opacities to be 50 and instead it's 56, you can always check it from here and change it from right here. Things which are responsive, which are marked, every single property inside XD will be here. So if you want to do a quick checkup or if you want to do a quick cleanup, this will show you all the areas that can be cleaned or things even like 5.11. Oh, what's this 5.11? Let me quickly select this and let me change it to 5 rather than 5.11. The next plugin is by the same guy who created the scaling plugin and it's called Todo, and it's absolutely what we needed inside XD. So if I quickly select Todo, it will basically create a to-do list on the left here. So I can say, okay, new task. So title can be subscribe to my channel, of course. And I can add a description or a note inside this, things like click on bell icon. And I can even give this a certain color code. So in this case, maybe it could be things like purple. So it will basically mark this as purple. And if I go back inside this plugin itself, I will see a to-do list which says subscribe to my channel, click on bell icon, and a purple mark is here. So it basically helps you differentiate. A trick I use is I mark it as either red or green. Red as in I've not done it. Green as in I've finished this work. So that will help you, you know, differentiate different kinds of tasks in the to-do list here. I think it is a much needed plugin. Something I wish there was a shortcut for in XD. I would die for that. The next plugin is for one of the most useful features inside XD called the Repeat Grid. All of you guys using XD have used Repeat Grid and you guys love that feature. This brings more functionality, more accessibility, and better stuff inside the Repeat Grid feature in XD. So I'm quickly going to update this because I feel they updated it recently. I'm going to quickly jump into XD to show you how this works. I'm going to quickly create on the Repeat Grid button, and I'm going to duplicate this or create a quickly a Repeat Grid right here, and I'll just increase the spacing so that you can see. Now let's add some superpowers to this. If I quickly click on repeater, it will quickly say generate, and it will generate a bunch of things that we can do inside these repeat grids. So for example, I want to add a bunch of portraits of different people inside this. How can I quickly do that? I'll quickly say, okay, I need a bunch of guys to be there inside this one repeat grid right here. I'll quickly click on this right here and I'll say add. Or I can quickly just say shuffle and it'll shuffle it. As you guys can see, it has added a bunch of images to my repeat grid. And if I add more elements, as you can see, it'll keep on adding more images, and unlimited images can be added with this. Again, this could be a bunch of different people, businesses, so different images for different purposes. You can even search on Unsplash. So if I want something like color, or if I want something like waterfall, whatever I like, it will add it, and I can quickly shuffle and it'll add this inside these repeat grids right here. Now that's not the only thing you can do with this plugin. You can even click on sort, and what it will do is it'll allow you to randomize image. So as you can see, it's randomized the way the images are displayed. You can even quickly say resize, and what it will allow you to do is select the number of elements you want. So if you want only 4 columns right here, it will change the repeat grid for you. And if I click on resize, only 4 elements will remain in my repeat grid. Rows, if I want, say, 20 rows, you can quickly resize and it'll add 20 rows to it. Yes, you don't have to do any manual labor of scrolling or dragging things around. It can be done here with specific numbers. Now, this is a funny one. It's called Pastry. And what it allows you to do is import images from any website you like. There are so many cool websites I wanted to download images from, but a lot of websites don't even allow you to do that. As you can see, there are a bunch of these cool images, which a lot of these are animated, but what if I could get some of these directly into my project? I could do that simply by copying the GitHub URL from here, going back into XD and pasting the URL inside here and say load. It might take a few seconds depending on your internet speed or depending on how fast your machine moves. As you can see, it's added it into my XD file right here. If I click on any one of these, it will just bring it up onto my artboards or inside this here. A lot of things which we didn't even think are images, but are images actually. All the icons, the logos, the designs, everything has been imported in the form of an image. It also shows the dimensions right here. So if you want to look at certain dimensions of an image, you can even see that. And the best part is it even imports GIFs. Yes, GIF support is there, even though you really can't see it animated inside XD. It's good to know that these are GIFs and you can use it in your projects. It's absolutely fantastic. All right, guys, that was it for today's video. Sorry for this horrendous face right here. But subscribe to my channel for videos every Monday and Thursday. I will post such content every week. And make sure you join me on Clubhouse, on Instagram, all the good stuff. Links will be in the description. I'll see you every Monday and Thursday, same time, same place. Until next time, take care of yourself. God bless.